We wanted to infuse technology to support our students' learning.
The students were more engaged in their lessons.
The whole culture had shifted.
Poverty is very prevalent in Talladega County, I think, due to the lack of industry. This was the huge Avondale textile mill. I think everyone knows someone who's lost a job here at Avondale.
When he was a student at Winneboro, Daryl was a student at risk, a high needs child, trying to make it in a world of poverty. I mean, they're deemed homeless because you're just literally moving from one place to another.
Both my parents, they didn't finish high school. And I was in special education because of my hearing and my speech impediment. When the technology came in, I was one of the few people who knew how to use it. The computers gave me a new way to communicate with people. And it kind of broke me out of the shell. You know, I just blossomed out into, you know, social butterfly, I guess I may say.
So the transformation from this quiet, shy child was through the culture shift at Winneboro, through the use of technology.
Project-based learning has served not only Winneboro High School, but schools across Talladega County extremely well. We wanted to infuse technology to support our students' learning. And most importantly, we wanted to empower students to really own their learning. And we want our teachers to deliver instruction in new and meaningful ways. January of this coming year, we will actually have a one-to-one student-to-computer ratio in all of our, in our high schools.
When you're done with the quiz,
each student has a MacBook Pro, they have the devices 24 hours. The way the technology ties in is now that they have a resource where they have limitless information at their fingertips.
Presenting a lesson traditionally has lost its effectiveness, and that's where project-based learning came, because now we can do it digitally. And now in geometry class we're saying, okay, how can building a bridge, how does that lead to other occupations? Then we provided them some apps that we found on the iPad. It allowed them to create different bridges and use different supplies or materials just so they could understand how a bridge needs to be structurally sound.
This is 150, so we've got the requirement, so good job on that.
The thing that sets Talladega County aside for me is the way they've gone about this entire process. They engaged their faculty, identified that they had an issue with student learning, brainstormed them all the various things they needed to do to shift their thinking about what teaching and learning looks like in the 21st century, and then decided how the technology fit into that process.
Talladega County school system is known statewide for our professional development. And we pride ourselves in the fact that our teachers are our primary leaders of our professional development.
I'm always humored when people ask me about teachers being on board.
Who's the voice of some kind of?
Because I don't see it that way.
Sometimes you have to provide.
You give them choice. You tell them, come up with a plan for students. How are you going to take them to the next level? When they design it, there's no need to try to figure out how to get someone on board. It's their design.
How you play?
All right. I want you to, in fractions, add each of these measures.
OCASE is math and music. Every single lesson, it had to integrate math and music.
Project-based learning works best if you have like a marriage, two people working together, and oftentimes different content areas. Today, they were creating their rhythms using an iPad, iWrite Music app.
When I arrived at Winneboro, the students were 33% proficient on the Alabama Reading and Math Test, and after a full year of implementation of OCASE, they were at 72%. That told Mr. Lawrence and I that what we were doing was truly effective.
Kids want to come to school because they understand why they're doing what they're doing in class and has relevance to their lives. Even a rural system, even some of our poorest areas, can really transform teaching and learning if they begin with the right place.
Because you have it in that you're going to study for 27 months.
The access to technology at a high poverty school is so necessary. It evens the playing field for all of our students.
Good job.
Education-wise, to be at the bottom and then being in the top 10 is pretty big for me. I got a full two-year scholarship to Central Alabama Community College. I believe that if I go on with my college education and get the job I wanted, I'll break the cycle for poverty in my family.